Hey everyone, I'm Ruth. Welcome back to another tutorial. This time it's about skin tones in colored pencils. When we talk about skin tones in colored pencils, we have quite a few options. We can buy a full set of colors. We can buy a skin tone set, we can buy single skin tones, but we can also do the blending ourselves. If you think it's too hard, please stay with me and I will show you how to blend these skin tones with these colors. Red, yellow, blue and the white for blending. So, let's get right into the tutorial. For the first skin tone, I start with a light layer of yellow. I use a very light hand for this layer. Then I go in with red. And use a very light hand as well. Very little pressure on the pencil, so you don't damage the tooth of the paper. And then I go in with my yellow again, and then my red. And the white pencil to blend the layers together. Here I use a little more pressure to blend these layers together. Now I go in with my red again. Put a little more pressure and then with the white again to blend it out. Then I use my yellow again. Blend it together. And again, a light layer of red. Some more yellow. And the white to blend it together. And again, some yellow, and you already see the skin tone coming through. Some red again, almost no pressure on the pencil, and the white to blend it out. And I don't say you should always blend the skin tones yourself. It's perfectly fine to use the skin tones from the sets, but I think it's really handy to know how to blend your own skin tones, and also fun to do. So So I keep going in with the red and the yellow and then the white for blending until I think the color is right. For the second skin tone, I start with red. Again, a very light layer with little pressure on the pencil, so you make sure you don't damage the tooth of the paper. Then I go in with the white. I blend it into the red. Then I go over this with yellow, very light hand. And another layer of red. More yellow. And the white to blend it all together. And again with the white, I put a little more pressure on the pencil than I do with the colors. And I go over it with the red again and the yellow, still with a very light hand. And the white to blend it out. And that's it for the second skin tone. And for the third skin tone, I start with a light layer of red again. And it's really important not to push too hard on the pencil. I keep repeating this, so you won't damage the tooth of the paper. And if you do press too hard, it will become impossible to put more layers on top. For the next layer, I use my yellow again with a very light hand, of course. And a layer of blue. And really, really light this blue. Almost no pressure at all. And then I go in with the white to blend this all together. So now you might think this really doesn't look like a skin tone at all. But just keep going and eventually you will see that it's really becoming a skin tone. Another layer of blue, a light layer again. And another layer of red. A little more pressure on the red. And then the white to blend it all together. And here we use a little more pressure to really blend the colors together. And then we go in with the red again with a light hand. The yellow. And now you begin to see the skin tone. Some more red on top of it. And the white to blend it all together. and another layer of red. Yellow. Really not a lot of pressure. Some more red on top of it. Little more yellow. And then again the white. And that's it for the third skin tone. And for skin tone number 4, I start with blue as my first layer. And again with a very light hand. And then I go over it with my red. And a layer of yellow. And some red again, with a little more pressure. And the white to blend it all together. And I go in with my red again. Some more blue, yellow, some more red and yellow, and you already see the skin tone coming through. Then the white for blending. Another layer of red. And blending with the white. Again some red, and a little more blue on top of all these colors. Yellow, and again some more red. A little more yellow. And again the white for blending. And again, some more red. I repeat this until I'm happy with the color. Yellow and the white again. And that's it for skin tone 4. For skin tone number 5, I start with the blue again. Very light layer with a light hand and I already put a second layer of blue on top of that and a layer of red and here I put a little more pressure because it has to become darker. I need more color, more pigment into this start of the skin tone, and I start blending it out with the white pencil. And then I go in with my red again, put a little more pressure again, and you can already see the skin tone. And the white for blending. And another layer of red. Some more blue on top of this. A little more red. And the white for blending. Another layer of red. And that's already it for the fifth skin tone.
Before we get into the last skin tone, I want to say to you that you can use any good quality pencil to do this. I use the Caran d'Ache Luminance to blend these skin tones, but you can also use your Faber-Castell Polychromos, you can use your Derwent Colorsoft, you can use your Prismacolors for this. No problem, if it's just a good quality pencil, it'll do the job. So, let's get back to the tutorial.
And for the last skin tone, I start with blue again. Again, I go a little darker than the other skin tones. And then I go in with the red, also a little darker, a little more pressure. And yellow, a light layer of yellow, and the blue again. Another layer of red. And then I put more pressure on the pencil, as you can see. It's getting really darker. Some more yellow on top of it. And another layer of blue. And another layer of red. And remember, with colored pencil, it's really important to build the colors up with layers, not only to get depth, but also because it's really hard to go from dark to light. Instead, you have to go from light to dark. So start light and go darker really slowly. So you can see where you want to put the highlights, where you want the shadows to be, or where they have to be. And yeah, just build it up really slowly. So here I am with my red again. And the yellow. And as I said before, I'm just building up the colors with layers and repeating this over and over again until I'm happy with the color. And a tiny bit of white for blending, and that's the sixth skin tone. And this is the final result.
Thank you very much for watching my video. If you liked it, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Hit the notification bell to get informed when a new video comes out. If you have a comment, please leave it down below. And you can share my video with all your friends. Thank you. Bye.